Oh, she's got a. How can we stop that?
Some?
How can we stop that? Maybe if you move closer to Mark.
It's not fine, it's going to look good for the camera.
That's better.
Put your feet down and sit forward.
No, just keep my feet up and then sit up and be higher.
Yeah. Sit so right on your back.
I've got plenty of room here, look. Come on, this way.
Oh, dude, it's fine.
Come on, this way. I need to be closer to the camera,
too. Do it, you're told.
Is it comfy?
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Terrace Talk. Here we are with Mark and Therese, and we're going to have a little interview today. Wanting to know how the journey is going with you two. Once the revival started, what's been happening? The experience that you've been going through so far. Can you put it in words?
Yeah.
Do you remember when you first met? When you first saw each other, how did that go down? Was it nice? I'm asking you, Mark.
Oh, sure.
I'm put it like that.
Sure. You chime in whenever you want.
Sure's not good enough.
Was it lovely? Because it was.
How did you feel meeting Trays?
It was wonderful.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You excited?
Yeah.
Mm. Nice feeling. Absolutely. And for you?
Nervous,
yeah,
as you always are when you meet someone,
yeah, and when you got over the nervousness,
yeah, it was a good night actually.
And when did it start to get intense, your relationship, you know, when you got in the deep?
Intense.
In the teeth.
You're probably a month after that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and?
It's,
tell the brothers and sisters how it was.
Been in the tents ever since. In the tents, mate.
Don't brag.
I mean intense, not intense. Intense, yeah.
Yeah, well, that's normal when you first come together, you have to go through a process. Even if someone's been divorced, you've got to do that knitting together, especially if you're in Yahusha. She wasn't in Yahusha at first.
Mm-hmm.
She hadn't made up her mind about things. She didn't know about Yahusha.
Mm-hmm.
Then you had to express all that to her. And of course, when you do that, sparks fly.
Yeah.
And what happened?
You
when?
Can't
when?
So
what? When?
Happened.
How? What year? What stage?
That's what
phase?
We're saying.
It's 4 years
the stage
ago.
You went through, knitting yourselves together.
Mm.
You know.
Mm.
And well,
then we had a lot of interference.
Yes.
As well.
Yeah.
Within our relationship from his ex.
Yes.
So.
Yeah.
It was.
Wasn't pleasant.
No.
Yeah. Well, it's normal. Yahusha puts us in places that we have to see if we're going to make it through, you know? See if you guys are going to stick to your word and go through it. When did Mark tell you about Yahusha?
That was the day that he took me to your place.
Pretty
much. Yeah.
It's about a week in, 2 weeks in.
All right. And he told you about Yahusha.
Mm-hmm.
And? You say, oh, you're going to meet a couple of freaks, they're real religious.
Oh, no, no, it was, they're all hairdressers, so you better make sure your, hair done, your hair's done well.
Oh, darling, you have hair down here then.
That pressure was on me, wasn't it?
You didn't really have to worry, did you? You look at it. And so he told you the day before he hit you with us.
Yeah, pretty much.
And what did you think of what he said to you? Do you remember what he explained to you?
No. No, I don't.
What about you? Do you remember what you said to her?
How did you approach
her? Talking about we'd met and we'd been messaging on and off for a few weeks.
Will they be able to hear you?
Oh,
come on, a bit louder.
Yes, I can.
I can't really remember. It was about marriage, I think. What I believed.
Already?
What I believed marriage was.
All right.
Because when you meet someone online and you have great chemistry and out in the world, people just sleep together. Well, I didn't feel like that.
Yeah.
Her morality is not like that either, but she didn't have the same belief I did at that stage. So I just had to explain to her, if this gets heavy and we want to go there, I believe that's marriage. So I just, as long as you don't have to believe what I believe at this stage, but I just want you to know what I believe. I probably wouldn't recommend it now, but at that phase, after being divorced, we talked and it was like, hey, where are you going to find a believer out there? So we talked a bit and he said, well, as long as the person understands what you believe, you can't live under the same house, it'd be hard. But and then by words, behaviours, all of this and everything, she did the miraculous. I didn't think she'd come through like this at all. But it started on the subject of marriage. Because when you've been married for 15 years and it's pretty hideous towards the end.
That long?
So is she. Pretty hideous towards the end. You start, when you're a free single person, you start thinking, oh, what have I missed out on and everything? So you want to get back in there, but you don't want to do it the wrong way.
So you both had lots of baggage when you met.
Yeah.
And then you had to work through the baggage. And there was interference from the old bag.
The old wife, the old husband, the kids, the parents, you name it. Baggage.
How was that going through all that?
Agony.
Well, you're here now. Mm.
Yeah,
that's all past.
You can't even remember it.
Isn't it?
It's wonderful.
It's been 5 years now, hasn't it?
Or yeah.
Longer.
End of 2017, so been 5 years.
Yeah. A lot of water's been...
Next week.
A lot of water's been under the bridge since then.
A deluge.
Yeah. Well, you had to knit two families together.
Mm.
And that would be very problematic. How did you two feel watching that from each other, knitting of the family together?
How did you feel
watching your two families trying to knit together?
I hated it.
Do you find that they've knitted together now more?
Yeah.
And what's the catalyst for that?
Moving down here was a big catalyst.
Yeah.
Taking away the devices was another big catalyst. And then the prayer session was a big catalyst because they all started, tuning into you.
Well, they didn't move in it when you first started, did they?
No, we remember all the things we used to try and print out over the years and sit at the table and they would just be...
Humorous.
But it all would have been.
Us, mainly.
It all would have been part and parcel of where they're at now.
Yeah.
All the things you tried to do.
Yeah.
Right. But now you're sitting there with the word.
Ricky Bar was the other big one.
And you're bringing that. That was one of your son's suggestions to do that.
Yeah.
You grabbed hold of it and said, "This is Yahusha."
Yeah.
And now it's on tape every day, pretty much every day.
Yes.
And there's been a massive growth when, like, we've been watching it, and there's been a massive growth, hasn't there?
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Certainly has.
And now you've got three that are making videos and teaching, learning to teach.
Yeah.
You've encouraged them to come into it, and they're starting to bring the word, and that's really going in, because you can watch them as they're reading, and they're thinking while they're doing it. You can watch their face and everything. This all changes going on in them. They're starting to realize, because they're going through the Gospels. Going through the Gospels was a wonderful step. That was your idea. You got that from Yahusha to do the Gospels.
Yeah.
And now you've done two, and there's another two coming, isn't there?
Yeah.
And they're similar stories. Mm. So it's a process of feeding.
Yeah.
And it's making them all grow and think. They've changed so much. Every one of them has had their own changes. So it's been a battle for you guys to keep the routine going, get up every morning, get them there together, have their breakfast, then do the brekkie bar, then after that you've got to get ready to go to work and to school and drop the kids off. And, you know, it's a rigorous routine, isn't it?
Yeah.
And then you're picking them all up in the afternoon, and some are walking home, and, you know, then there's food to make for 10 people. It's all happening, and you're right in this routine of life, and you're doing two meetings a week, two praise sessions a week, and they're all starting to play instruments, you know, and come through, and you're getting help for them where they need it, you know. It's been an incredible experience when you look at it. Very hard, very difficult, plus you're getting attacked by the enemy all the time not to go on. How do you feel about that happening to you? Were you that aware of demons as you are now?
No.
Tell me the difference that you see now. Tell us the difference.
Between then and now? We weren't at all effective. We weren't doing anything worth attacking, really. I felt a little bit of an attack start coming when I started working on the scriptures, but ever since the prayer session, I've been down here, and everything with the morning is happening, the attack's just been dialed right up. The feeling you're getting from this right now, at the risk of going down a rabbit hole, is because I screamed at her this morning. Screamed my head off at her.
Again?
Swore at her. And screamed and screamed and screamed at her, and stormed out of the house and went to work and left everybody in it.
Oh! That's
the unresolved feeling you might be sensing between
we're
us
not
right
sensing
now.
A feeling.
Well, I'm just giving it to you.
You're very clever, both of you hiding stuff.
So, of course, Victor's coming with an interview today.
Sorry.
It's my suggestion.
Christopher suggested it. How's your experience
Yahusha has
going?
A wonderful sense of humor, doesn't he?
I just thought, you know, no one really knows you two, what you've been through, what you're going through. And I thought it would be good to have a terrace talk with both of you. I mean, you see how we feel about what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And we're onlookers.
Yeah.
We're not having that experience. You two are, and it's a massive growth.
Yes.
We're actually a bit jealous that you're getting so much attention from the ocean. Well, you are. So what happened this morning? What did you scream at?
Something about medication, and Hunter putting things around the table that I'd asked him to do it, and she didn't want to do it, and she was telling him, and I just took it personally, off my face.
Oh.
Yeah. Off my
you
face.
All right,
I'm
you over
fine.
It? You're perfect to get over it.
I went up and I actually I went up and I explained to Hunter the reason why I didn't want him touching Robert's medication that's been prescribed.
Yeah.
It's a class A drug that it's they actually have to call the federal government in order to get the prescription certified and everything.
Yeah.
He understood it. I tried to explain it to him and he was just off his face.
Oh. Emotional.
Because he thought I was wrong. Mm. Went, no.
That said in the past tense.
It's a medication that...
Very dangerous.
That no child should be touching at all.
Yeah.
Especially without supervision. Hunter understood it. He received what I said. He said, I'm not angry with you, I'm not upset with you. I'm telling you no because it's not something that you should be touching.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And so you're having incidences and circumstances like this where you both have to deal with your emotions and feelings, and it's a roar, and it's all happening. Sometimes that comes across in the morning, but what you've been through with the kids, they've all settled right down, you know, and they're reading so much better. So all these things that you're going through that they're witness to and the whole thing, you could feel as though you're hypocrites, but I don't think like that. I don't think it looks like that at all. You know, it's an incredible job. I wish many more people would take on board what you two are doing and bring it into their home.
Yeah.
If they do, beware, because Yahushua said he's coming with a sword.
Yes.
He didn't come to bring peace, and it certainly isn't peaceful, is it?
No.
What you're going through. I just want to assure you guys that, you know, we're right behind you. We're praying for you both. And we believe in what you're doing. And it's very difficult to find your way in what's right or not. But you both forgive each other all the time. I'm seeing that happen. And you're going through this clash and the kids are trying to split you apart. No one's understanding your side. No one says anything about that. So I'd like to make it clear to the brothers and sisters that turmoil and the agony and the torment of wanting your kids to give up the world, and they're fighting you both on every encounter so they don't have to do it.
We've got two kids in our house that are constantly setting each of us up. Two kids. One is Robert setting up Mark. The other one is Hunter setting me up.
So what are you doing about that between yourselves? You've stated that. Are you in agreement with what she's stating or not? Do you need more understanding from Therese to understand what's happening?
I can understand what she's saying. I wouldn't say that Robert sets me... I don't blame... I look at my... If I've let myself get riled up by him, then I'm an idiot. That's how I look at it. And if any, it's for discipline, I discipline him. But I wouldn't be blaming him for riling me up.
Oh, it's very hard.
It's me that chooses, because on a normal day, he can't.
I've watched it, it's constant. He's at you all the
time. But normally, I just hear it.
But it's a setup. It's simple. That is a setup.
Yeah.
Well, I'm looking for
it's the spirit. It's the demon. No, it's the spirit setting you up. Now, you know, and that nagging all the time.
Yeah.
You're aware that it's there.
And I haven't done anything about it.
Just so go on.
I haven't done anything about it. And if I don't change about him, about regarding him, there's no growth. So most days, we just have a pretty cool relationship with him.
But that's still happening.
Gets intensified when we come around the word.
Yes.
So that's mainly where I have to speak out if you deal with him when he acts up.
And also Hunter is, you know, all the time, it's the spirit in him, and attacking Therese because of what she's bringing and how she's come. And it's the same nagging, and you're aware that it's there and it can really affect you.
But what a job to take on.
Yeah.
10 kids. Yeah. There's still 2 down there that are hanging around and coming and going.
Yeah.
8 kids, 2 down there, 6 here.
Yeah. Oh, 8 kids.
10 all up. Us.
With you, yeah. So it's incredible, and you coming out, you've only got 2 and you've got 6 more on top of you.
Mm.
So it's an incredible job to take on. I think that you're handling it wonderfully. You don't feel like that because you're upset with each other, because it's a full-on, everyday, all-day thing that's going on, you know. And after the morning, and then they're all away while you're working, you still got to get on with each other at work and let go of what's happened.
The clients today would say, no, something came up about, because everyone's still got Bali on their mind because of flights and everything. Every second person's going to Bali. Oh, we went there, yeah. How was that? I'm like, oh, yeah, it was good. And then my mind, I'm thinking, that was a lifetime ago. Where the hell were we there? Peace and quiet and together. What's that feel like again? Like you just look in the mirror and forget who you are.
Yeah.
So, but that's where we're at. There's a lot of hate going on right now.
Between you two?
Yeah.
What is
expressions on the faces?
What is it? Well, we can't see that.
Can't see it.
It's all in
it's
you.
Not happening.
You don't look like you're feeling like.
You mastered the fakery quite well.
You both are experts.
It's called being in business, I think.
Yeah, well. So, what's going on?
What's going on?
Let's do it in front of the brothers and sisters. Let's work
it
out.
I opened it up.
Oh, so you've
opened
it
up. I did.
Well, what's going on?
Yeah.
What are you still angry at each other for now?
Because I can see it won't end until I lay down on the floor and kiss her feet and humbly apologise.
Yeah. You did that the other
some
day.
Some days I just don't feel like doing that.
Oh,
so
I see.
My ego, I guess.
It's the constant.
My ego is a problem. Oh. I don't like being a doormat every single day.
Well, I've got a suggestion for you. Why don't you just forget about the 3 rules and don't do it?
Do it my way. Yeah.
Do it your way till you.
I did that this morning. And that was
what? How did that affect you?
I've been sick of not speaking out for most of my life, so I've been testing the waters on everybody. And most of the time when I do it, I just. It didn't do anything. It actually made everything worse. So I just shut my face. What was the point of that? What was the point of going in there? She was just working around and go and interview and talk to everybody and prove me wrong anyway. So prove that what I didn't see happen didn't happen the way I saw it. Try and prove everybody. So I just.
So you did see what you saw.
I saw what I saw.
And you said you should.
I showed my face about it.
You should.
I should shut up, but I didn't. I went in there.
That's where you got it.
Because people have been setting the table for 5 years now. People have been putting out the vitamins. People have been putting out the drugs. People have been putting out the juices. People have been putting out the. But on this particular morning, we're going to tell them off about it. So I told her off about it. And this is what's happened since then. So in that situation, the 3 rules would have been much better. Shut your face. Hunter's got pretty thick skin.
Hunter's got
pretty thick skin.
Yeah.
Thicker than mine, I think. I admire it.
Yeah.
So, had to. So, just let it fly.
She doesn't seem to be as perturbed as you are about it to me. Am I wrong?
Not at all. I actually sat all the kids down after he'd stormed out of the house. And I explained to them the situation with Robert's medication and how hard it actually is for the doctors to get it.
What has that got to do with anything to do with telling Hunter off?
Getting all the vitamins and going like this in front of everybody.
I said not that one, and it was Robert's medication.
Aren't they wonderful brothers and sisters? Ridiculous. We love them.
It's ridiculous.
How
can you get to anything useful in your life when you've got all this rubbish going on?
Yeah, well, it's all part of it.
It's all those little details.
Oh, it's the little things, isn't
bloody
it?
Picking things out that you did this and you did that. You walked through there and you had a move here and you did that. And all those little details, and the demons are there all the time. This is what the brothers and sisters don't understand, don't see and don't talk about, that the attack because of what you're doing, and you haven't dropped out and stopped doing the process, you keep going, and that's why they're screaming and wanting you to, you know, to back down. And I see you guys are backing down anyway. You're still going to keep going.
Let me explain to you what I'm upset about.
You're talking to
we're having to issues with
he's talking to we're ha-
having issues with the You're teenagers looking
I'll
at
turn around that.
We're having okay. issues with the teenagers because they won't walk the dogs, and you've had to do it, and you've got sore legs and sore hips. Penis stepping up and helping you. We've got those sort of things happening every morning, frustrations. We've got other kids who want to sleep in, other kids that have to get up for breakfast. All these things happening.
How many days do they have to walk?
Every day.
The dogs?
Yeah.
Every day.
Well, on the brekkie bar mornings, not in Shabbat, on the brekkie bar mornings, because then they're exhausted and they don't bark as much.
Well, why don't you just say, I'm taking the dogs to the pound tomorrow.
And in the middle of it all...
What would that do to them?
I'll go get up. So we've got frustrations with that going on, and then in the middle of it all, wondering if anybody's going to get up for this or that, or are they getting up to ride with me this morning, or are they getting whatever. Hunter's up, dressed. Most mornings happy, doing the dishwasher. There'll always be three or four things wrong with the dishwasher, because we can't let him have that. And then we go over to the table, and I asked him to back me up because I had a late night and I was feeling a bit of a headache. So I said, can you start setting the table or whatever? You know, so he's the only one up and around and happy there. So then when I see all this stuff coming at him all the time, I just think there's all these other frustrations going on with other kids that won't show up or won't do this or won't do that. The one person that's here is getting a barrage. So this morning I'd had enough.
Right.
I don't have the right to have enough. I don't own
You have every right.
I don't own myself.
This is normal what you're going through. I wish you'd understand it. It's normal.
Yeah.
I'm sick of suffering silently.
How'd you like to be going through this, brothers and sisters? Wow, what a barrage on your emotions. What do you think of the rule number one? Don't take
anything personal.
And it's anything. Where do you both stand with that one? That's what the scripture says. Be offended at nothing. Don't take anything personal. That's the word of Yahusha. That's instruction for us.
Anything.
Anything, nothing. Don't take nothing
everything.
Personal. Everything, yeah, no. They take everything. And it's so hard to get out of that. Order in your mind about not getting offended.
Your rights.
Yes.
But if it's a law, it's from scripture.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you two just, it means nothing
Chuck
to you.
It out.
Well, you're not chucking it out. You know it. You just, when it comes at you,
Self-control.
Both, you've got to look and say, what is this? What's going on? You've got to hold yourself and don't enter into it. What's that scripture about? You know, stubborn people or something. It's like grabbing a bear by the ears or something. Some scripture that says that, if you take it personal. I don't know why you won't do that for yourselves. It's very simple. Don't take anything personal.
I haven't taken anything this morning personal. I'd only said about Robert's medication. I don't care what he's doing.
Yeah.
I can see that. Yeah.
But you're angry.
I'm angry because
but
in,
so,
the, in the
no,
salon,
no, no, stop.
He was even
no,
worse.
No, stop. You've taken it. Personal.
What he was doing in the salon,
well,
I took personal.
What
yes.
right do you have when he says, don't do it? What right do you have to do it when he says, don't do it? You're breaking his command, so what are you going to get? And whatever you do or say to him affects him, vice versa. Unless you clear it up, you're just in the cycle, the hot wash. That's what the three rules are for. You pull, you press the button, stop, open the door and get out and have a breath. You know? That's what you need to do, give yourselves a breather. That's what I hoped Bali would do for you.
Well, I tried to talk to him in the salon before we started. He just ignored me.
Yep. I didn't want to go off anymore. I just
ignored me, so I just left him with it.
Did you take it personal?
No.
Well, it looks like you did.
No, that
but you're angry when you talk
about
it. You've
got no rights, lovey. You haven't
that
got any rights.
That wasn't the part that I took personal.
Yeah,
that was the part when my client was talking about some spray that you can get. And I knew that was directed at me when he said, oh, where do I get that?
She was talking about her kids.
No.
People, wasn't she?
She was talking about people and getting F-off spray.
Oh, because she gets, as a client around the corner, has a shop.
As well.
She said they've got this new spray out called F-off spray. Because she said, I'm sick of people all day, every day.
Yeah.
I said, oh, yeah, why don't you get some of that? So we've got a house full. It was a joke.
Yeah.
Apparently, it was about her.
It
was directed at me.
Okay, well, again, if it's directed at you and you know it, should you take it personally?
No.
What should you do?
No.
Yeah. And you've got to feel righteous. If he's had a go at you or you believe he's had a go at you, then your behaviour should be the contrary to it. And you don't seem to be putting those three rules to yourself. You're obliterating them.
Yeah.
When you come down to brass tacks and you're looking at the word, don't take anything personal. Let people have it. Do unto others as you would have them do unto. So you're doing to him what you would hope he'd do to you? Are you doing to him?
No.
That's right. So you don't let him have it. So you cop it. And then in our arrogance, like Mikey, just lied the other night when we're all together, said, no, I didn't do it. And said you were a liar. And everyone else was a liar, yet everyone was there witnessing what he did. He was just stunned. So that's how you're going to be stunned and angry, if you don't take on these principles. So why aren't you, you've been in the movement as long as we have, why aren't you applying it to myself? Am I taking this person? Am I letting her have it? You've actually got to let her have whatever she does or says. If you don't agree,
with anyone.
You
shut up.
And keep it.
To yourself.
And leave it, give it to Yahusha, and he'll fix it. You'll watch it happen if you do that. It's not going to work unless you
do it.
And you have to clear what's going on between the two of you up.
And at the same time, you've got to try and be active.
Yeah. Well, what's going on between you? She said she wants to have your knowledge. So what's going on between you?
Well, it must be a competition.
So you've got a competition.
Yeah.
Why is she competing with you?
Because the children respond to me differently than they do to her. She thinks it's because of knowledge. It's actually because of relationship.
That's your knowledge then. Well, you express the will.
That's a day-to-day, how you talk, treat, work. Okay, behavioural knowledge,
Knowledge, you've got to know where you're at. I'm not going there. I'm not. And set a precedent for her so she can see this behaviour emanating out of you. She can't rile you up. And you've got to let her rile you up. You've got to let her try. How does that work?
Doesn't go anywhere.
Talk to us about it.
Because
if you succeed in it, it doesn't.
If Chris just didn't get riled up, I'd feel more furious because my work, my urge of trying to do it, my ambition of trying to get him to blow, like go mad, it, you know, if he goes mad and blows up, I feel better. If he doesn't, it comes back on me and it just went around and around all the time. I was wrong until I actually got sick of the dreadful pain of the consequences constantly coming on me. So that's why, you know, I finally woke up to myself. This isn't working. He's so just letting me have it all the time.
Do you think?
And it works.
I've achieved it.
Yeah, I do.
So this
I'm listening to you.
This is the same for everyone.
Yeah.
You've got to get through where one of you is actually not going to do it. One of you is not going to give in and take offence.
Go off your face.
And let the other one have it.
Yeah.
If you want to be in a competition, that's the best one.
Yeah.
That's why I win all the time.
You do.
Why don't you take the feather? Hey? When it comes to him, you could let him have it. It's no good saying, oh, I didn't take offence when you're angry. It's pretty obvious that you have taken offence. You're not in reality. And that's what I mean. If you're not in reality, you're not recognising you're being attacked constantly because of the work you were doing.
Yeah.
All the videos and everything you're putting out, oh, yeah, you might think it's any consequence, but it is, and it will be for the future.
Yeah.
Putting all that streamlined stuff, it's all bound so they can watch what your family come through. Look what they've come through from your efforts.
Yeah.
They're preaching, they're doing teachings, they're singing, they're
playing instruments.
Playing instruments. And at home, it's a bit of chaos, but you can still manage it much easier than what you did. The thing is,
we have to stay together.
Yeah. Sorry. She's saying sorry to you. Again.
Sorry. I had my head up my arse. I'm sorry.
Looks like there's tears.
Me?
Well, understanding when it comes to Robert's medication.
Serious.
It is serious. It's not something that a child should be touching.
I didn't understand.
Well, how come he's touching it? That's what I'm saying.
Because I just said to him, go put the vitamins on the table. You've got the vitamin C ones, you've got the Hunter's chewable ones, and you've got Robert's ones there. They're just all together. And I normally just put them all on the placemats right before the break. They have their juice, they take their stuff. I'm trying to give them
so
stuff
you
so they
did
get
wrong by letting Hunter.
I said, Hunter, can you do that?
So
my fault.
Obviously she's got a bee in the bonnet and wants to get them from that. Whatever you do is going to be wrong. She's going to get you because of how she's feeling.
Well, I was sick of being wrong and him being wrong, so I just screamed.
Took it personally.
Screamed the street out.
Yeah, and Satan's going, got him this morning. We got him beautiful this morning. So you have to fix up that thing where you want to get him. You're in a competition with him. You want to beat him with hairdressing. You want to beat him in lots of things. Yeah? Because you don't feel appreciated, I'd say. Is that it? And he wants to be appreciated too. So I had to give in my wanting Victoria to recognise me and recognise her in everything.
Even
the toenail polish, the colour. And I had to recognise she's got a crook at this and a crook at that and still love it.
It's very similar.
Kisses.
Yeah.
It's very similar. What's the same process?
We're walking a similar walk.
Mm. Of course. Yeah. Everyone has to. It's the same walk. Mm. You've got to put everything on the
water. Fire. Yeah.
Burn it up.
Yeah.
Don't go on with it, it's agony.
No, she's got to go on with what she feels until she can,
with it, Therese.
She can see that it's what? She can see that it's what?
Wrong.
Or? Wrong or right?
All right. Test
she's
it out.
She's got to walk
gotta prove
that
it.
Walk.
Yeah, you've got to prove it to yourself.
But one of you
has to give in first.
No, it's not giving in. Pull out.
Okay.
But the scripture says, don't do it.
Don't do it.
And if you go ahead and do it, what are you going to get?
Consequences.
Consequences.
You want consequences?
No.
Why?
They're not fun.
Well, what are you giving them to yourself for?
Stand
your ground.
Yeah.
And say, no, I'm going to do this rule faithfully.
Mm.
You've got to go down
to your death.
You know, the greatest amongst us is the least.
Yeah.
Do you want to get me and hurt me?
Get
me all
this,
the time?
Hurt you, no.
No. You don't
want
to get me and hurt me, really, do you?
Want.
It's only about
if
knowledge.
I can, if I can find a minute point,
yeah,
I
that's
enjoy
right.
it.
And
oh,
you can
hurt
teach
you,
me.
At all.
And you can teach me, and I don't mind.
No.
I didn't know that, mate. That
yeah.
was really good.
You just let me have it. You're free. That's it.
Yeah.
That's the way I should be.
You should be. All of them. If there's a problem.
Well, I'm waiting for them all to get into the word so they can.
You will. They'll know the word says this. I think they know enough of the word now.
Yeah.
You've got to bring them into where you're bringing them in, what Therese is doing. And what do you think about that? And did you know that? And did you realise that? And they're simple little questions. And they're knocking them out because they're not coming back.
No, they're not.
They're listening and taking it in and being stunned.
Mm.
You're a bit stunned that she's stunning them.
Stunned about the stunningness.
Yes. Yeah. Four gospels. You've got two more to go.
Yeah.
Just keep ploughing.
Mm.
But I don't think people realise how messy and hideous demons are, what they want to do in a person's home. It's up to you two guys to wake up and kick them out.
Mm.
Don't be afraid. Go straight on. The way Yahushua's showing you. You can only have it, you have to come together as one, and you have to walk that road together, the life that you have. And it's up to you to make it as pleasant as you can, but you're always going to get tempted and all sorts of horrible things coming at you, want your own way. And whatever you attempt to do to step out, Yahushua's going to be there, and he's going to show you whether he likes what you're doing or he doesn't. And the quicker you wake up to what he wants, better your life's going to be. All you have to do is check everything with the word.
Mm.
Say, I'm in a situation, what am I going to do here, Father? Instantly you'll get a scripture that suits the situation, and you'll just, oh, all right, I can see where I'm going now. I see that light there, that's where I'm going.
Mm.
You work towards that. We don't have that, we've got nothing.
No.
We know everything that's got to go on the altar, and there's new things that pop up that he wants us to put on the fire. If you're not willing to put it on the fire, more punishment.
Yep.
So you're both doing a wonderful job, and I really feel sorry for you that you're going through this, and it's heartbreaking, and the hate and the anger and the demons put in us towards each other, we have to pull it off. Peel it off, you know, and throw it in the fire, and don't allow ourselves to go to those places again. But it can only be done by the two of you.
Yeah.
No one else can interfere.
Yeah.
So we're there backing you up. Go for it, go for it, go for it. Hope you can see lots of things from this, brothers and sisters. I hope it opens your heart and your mind, and you're going to start to fight.
Yeah.
You want to say anything else?
No, I think it's amazing.
You've got to pay the questions.
No, but you've answered them all. I've gone through it.
You want to say anything?
No.
Sure you don't want to cap it?
Yes.
See you later, guys. Thanks for watching.
She capped it. Okay.
Bye.